All right, 9:01, we're turning to space headlines as we show you a view of Kennedy Space Center. We're looking live there. Crew 11, those astronauts are just hours away from starting a journey to the International Space Station. And we have team coverage for you this morning from our space coast. West 2's Paola Tristan Arruda is live at Space View Park, where people are gathering. They want to watch that launch in person. But we begin with West 2's Space Coast reporter. Megan Moriarty is live there at Kennedy Space Center this morning. And Megan, the rocket's right behind you. It's poised to launch in just about 3 hours.
And you can probably hear that loud noise right now. We have choppers above us as Crew 11 is set to pass by here in just seconds in the black Teslas that they take out to the launch pad. They just did their walkout, meaning that health checks went well. So that is a good sign. And weather is 90% chance favorable, so another good sign. Now, some exciting news. There are two rookies that will be on board this rocket, one of them being the commander. That's Zena Cardman. She was originally set to travel to the space station for the Crew 9 mission, but was bumped to allow for the return of NASA astronauts Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams, who stayed at the ISS after technical issues with the Boeing Starliner. Today's launch attempt will mark the sixth time the SpaceX spacecraft Endeavour will blast off into orbit, originally slated for only 5 missions. Commander Cardman touched on the efforts being made to ensure a safe flight to the ISS.
It takes a huge team of people to do this. They've been working nonstop for many months now, so with deep gratitude to that team for making sure that we'll be safe to fly.
Crew 11 will replace Crew 10, which launched in March this year. The crews will overlap for a week to ensure a smooth transition, and we'll be monitoring the launch right here at Kennedy Space Center. But for now, let's get over to Paola Tristan Arruda, who is monitoring the spectators who come out for these big launches. Paola.
Yeah, good morning, Megan. We've had some nature watchers out here and some people coming to just see the sunrise, maybe have breakfast at the park. But overall, we haven't seen too many people out here yet. Right now, we are seeing just a couple of people starting to set up. Of course, Space View Park is one of the most popular places to watch launches. We've seen people from all over come to this spot, especially for a crewed mission like this one. But for the most part, it's still pretty early, and it's going to be very hot. So we're starting to see some of the setup right now. One person who was out here this morning, though, Congressman Mike Haradopoulos, who represents the Space Coast, he talked about why missions like this one are so exciting.
Today, of course, we're putting up 4 astronauts, 2 of those Americans. They'll be going to the International Space Station, where so much science is conducted, to see how we can make medical breakthroughs, technological breakthroughs. It's truly exciting to be a part of the Space Coast.
And for the most part, as I mentioned, it's still pretty early, very quiet out here. We've seen a couple of people, though, that came to just scope things out. They're going to come, put chairs down, maybe grab some coffee, and then come back a little bit later. But again, the launch is just after noon today, and we will be out here to let you know when that happens and talk to people as they come to the park. For now, covering the Space Coast, live in Titusville, Paola Tristan Arruda, West 2 News.
And we are going to bring you that launch live on West 2 News at noon. We're continuing our team coverage that hour with Paola and Megan.